Alright then, YouTube hashtags, you can see them just below this video right now. But are they a legitimate way to grow your channel, or are they just a little bit of YouTube eye candy? Let's do this.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.com.
Hello video creators, I've got two questions to kick this one off. First of all, should I wear these glasses throughout an entire video? I cannot see a thing right now, I'm completely blind. However, do I look cool enough on camera to increase my audience retention? I'd really want to know the answer to this, so let us know in the voting card up there right now. The second and more serious question is, how have you been getting along with YouTube hashtags? We want to know in the comments below any success stories or complete catastrophes. Yeah, we're here to listen. My name is Rob, welcome to vidIQ. If this is your first time here, we are the YouTube tool and channel that aims to help you get more views and save time in the process. Our Chrome extension is free to download, a link is in the description. Now, YouTube hashtags, to summarize, if you include a hashtag word in your description, then it appears above your title. We've done a whole everything you need to know video about hashtags, so do check that one out if you're unfamiliar with what we're going to discuss. Now, while this is still relatively new and fertile ground, we've started to see particular user behaviors, patterns, and suggestions and strategies from other YouTubers. So here's five things we've learned about YouTube hashtags. First of all, there still seems to be some uncertainty about how hashtags work. Generally speaking, what you should be doing is including three hashtags in your description, and those should appear above your title. If you put a hashtag in the title, that's not going to appear above your title, just in the title itself. I'm saying title many times here. And then your title looks a bit weird with the black writing and then some blue hashtag writing. So we are recommending that you put hashtags just in your description. Some people seem to be a little impatient as well. They put the hashtags in and then they don't see those hashtags appearing above the title. Every time we've seen this comment, we've checked on the video and the hashtags have been there. So whether you just need to wait maybe 5 minutes, refresh your browser, close the window tab, a bit of patience is required. But as far as we know, there are no restrictions on using hashtags for any channel. Now, in saying this, there have been some examples of where hashtags don't work as they're expected to. A user wanted to try and use a hashtag audiophiles headphones. When they did that, it appears above their title in the video. When you click on that hashtag, however, the search results come back with zero, which is a little odd. We don't have any explanations for that at the moment, so there do seem to be one or two YouTube hashtag foibles right now. Another thing we've noticed is users reporting that hashtags are jumbled up with random spaces where they don't expect them to. That seems to happen when there are emojis in the vicinities of your hashtags. So if you are having problems trying to represent hashtags properly in your videos, maybe just clean up the text and characters around your hashtags, especially emojis, and that should fix the issue. So while we have user behavior on the one side, we've got YouTube's behavior on the other side. And this in particular is how hashtags are represented in search pages. And this could be an absolute game changer for hashtags in the future. For example, if you do a search for hashtag football, you'll first of all see what are called top videos, and it'll list three of those. You can click to see more. But immediately below that, you've got latest videos, which is curated in a lot less of a standard YouTube fashion. And you see all sorts of videos popping up here, some with very few subscribers, but posted very recently. And that's gonna dilute the way you use hashtags for discovery, because it doesn't seem as if they are as powerful for using as what you might call enhanced tags. Now, I'm sure a question you're all asking at the moment is that I'm testing these hashtags. How can I analyze the success or failure of them? Can I do that? The answer is yes. If you go to YouTube Analytics, then Traffic Sources and YouTube Search, your hashtag results will appear like all other YouTube searches in those analytics. The interesting thing that we've noticed so far is that the hashtags that we've been using have had very little impact on views and watch time, but ironically, the video we made about YouTube hashtags has gone to the top of our search terms and is doing very well for us. So maybe that tells you something more about trending topics than hashtags themselves. A very good point that's been raised about hashtags is, are they actually any use for your channel? Let's look at it from this point of view. You're basically putting a search term above your title, which when clicked, takes a viewer away from your content and doesn't necessarily show the viewer more of your content. So why would you want to do it? And it's a very valid point, because it seems to be that you can't dominate a hashtag with all of your videos. It may share one or two, but the way that YouTube is curating these hashtags, it seems to show all sorts of videos. So you could have a hashtag there that somebody clicks on 15 seconds into your video, and then you've lost them into the YouTube universe. So certainly something to think about. Are hashtags good for search and discovery? If the answer is no, what are YouTube hashtags good for? And the answer seems to be something a lot wider and bigger than just a single channel, and that's community and movement. Whenever somebody uses a hashtag, they're not necessarily trying to surface their own content, they're trying to join in on a global conversation. And that might be the route that hashtags go down on YouTube as well. For example, Tim Schmoyer is experimenting with the hashtag family team to try and encourage a movement of family vloggers all working towards the same goal and have their hashtags share similar content from similar video creators. So not necessarily promoting your content, but promoting an idea or a value. YouTube hashtags are still in their infancy, and I'm sure there's a lot more weird and wonderful stories for you to share on your own experiences with them. And we've just got one more final interesting tidbit. A special shout out goes to Bluebird RK, I think a Bangladeshi TV channel, which took our advice a little too literally and started using the three hashtags that we wanted to use on our channel, and they're using our hashtags and now completely dominating the search for those hashtags, which is a little weird and awkward, but that's one of those things. So we've talked quite a bit about the theory of YouTube hashtags here, but if you want to know how to use these hashtags in a functional sense, as we said at the top of the video, we've got a full tutorial right here. And if you want to know more about just tags in general, whether those be the old classic tags and the hidden ones and whether they're still relevant or not, we've got a playlist down there. Enjoy the rest of your video making day, and we'll see you on either of those videos right now.